bodies of Iraqis killed in this weekend's airstrikes were buried. With speeches from pro-Iranian leaders calling for America to be cleaned from the country. Iraq's Prime Minister visited the wounded in the hospital. The strikes aiming to punish Iraq and Iranian-backed groups for the attack that killed three US soldiers. But the Pentagon admitted that there are no reports of Iranians killed or injured. The Pentagon says Iran's Revolutionary Guard was, says Iran's soldiers. But the Pentagon admitted that there are no reports and Iranian-backed groups for the attack that killed three US soldiers. But the Pentagon admitted that there are no reports of Iranians killed or injured. The Pentagon says Iran's Revolutionary Guard was targeted, and 48 hours later, releasing some details of the impact, 84 buildings either damaged or destroyed this week. Friday night was just the beginning, National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan told NBC's Kristen Welk.
Have you ruled out strikes inside Iran?
I'm not going to get into what we
did. Now, Iran producing this highly produced video, warning the US not to target one of its ships, the MV Meshad, on the coast of Yemen, saying it's there to fight pirates. But the US has accused Iran of providing the Houthis with intelligence. Experts believe that's the Shad's real goal. They say it's a spy ship.
Wherever the Meshad goes, happens to be more or less where the Houthis happen to be targeting their anti-ship ballistic missiles, suicide drones, and suicide boats.
A claim that fits with tracking data reviewed by NBC News. The Iranian video today ends with US Navy carriers turning red and a threat.
Those engaging in terrorist activities, aka Meshad or similar missiles, jeopardize international maritime security and assume global responsibility for potential future international risks.
This exclusive NBC News video from our team on board the USS Dwight D. Eisenhower last night as the US and UK launched 36 strikes against 13 UK targets, today igniting demonstrations in Yemen, with the leaders declaring it will not make us scared.
Here joins me now from Iraq. Here, all of this happening with the backdrop of the Israel-Hamas war, of course, and there's a new effort on the diplomatic front there.
That's right, Kate. Secretary of State Blinken traveling to the region tonight to try to push again for a ceasefire in Gaza. He will stop in Saudi Arabia, in Qatar, in Egypt, in Israel, and in the West Bank. The Biden administration trying to deter Iran and achieve peace. Tonight, Kate, it looks like a battle